The NBA stands for nothing but actors, and they are also programming you. They moved the NBA to Walt Disney to harness that magic. Do you believe in magic? In a young girl's heart, how the music can free her whenever it starts, and it's magic.
Right, because this, otherwise, you look at the book, right, it breaks the whole, like, this is like magical. Right?
Yeah, you don't want to break the magic. This is like magic.
Yeah, you don't want to break the magic.
In this video, by way of the Holy Spirit of God and Jesus Christ, I will show you how the NBA is playing in the bubble. And most of y'all, they have taken in the bubble with them. It's all spiritual.
Nothing but actors. And they are also programming you to harness that magic. Nothing but actors.
It's all spiritual.
As one of the videos that we showed, these are the magicians on the court. You know, I do believe that a lot of witchcraft and all that goes behind the NBA as well, which means nothing but actors. It's like the veil was ripped off my face, that they tried to glue a mask to my face with this Baphomet circus, and it's like the Lord just ripped the whole thing off.
So Dr. Newman, you're saying that everybody wears a mask?
That's correct, Wendy. We all wear masks, metaphorically speaking. We suppress the id, our darkest desires, and adopt a more socially acceptable image.
Well, the book is, of course, The Masks We Wear by Dr. Arthur Newman. Thank you so much for being with us today.
All right, all started with JaVale getting shoved down the throat, so we're going to keep our timeline over here as we get more information, right? So we went from JaVale getting stuck down the throat, and then where we went? To him showing the Souls of Black Folk book. See, I've been telling people what's going on, but a lot of people just ain't listening. The NBA is going to make sure that you get programmed by this subjectiveness. They're going to make sure. If you are an avid NBA watcher, get ready to be programmed without a shadow of a doubt. Then once he pulled that book out, what he pulled out, y'all? Malcolm X book. So we saw just through JaVale's video that it's already starting off. It's already popping off. And if that wasn't enough, what'd he do? He showed the card out of his backpack that said, throughout the time in Orlando, there will be programming to learn more about social injustice and systematic inequalities. That's exactly what the NBA is set up to do, and that's what they're going to be doing. Look what's on the basketball court that they're playing at. Anybody see that? And the only reason I'm showing like pictures here, because every time I try to play a video, they have it choppy. So choppy, it don't make no sense, right? All right, so look, let's keep going. Do y'all remember back right here? Where there was a storyline that said that LeBron James' home was vandalized and somebody wrote the N-word on his gate? Remember that? Now, why did they spray it on LeBron James' gate? That's right, Mammy. They was planting the seeds of it way back then. But why did they spray it on LeBron James' gate and not nobody else's gate? Because LeBron James was going to swoop back around a little bit later when they got to Orlando, and he was going to be the face of the inequality, just like they chose Kaepernick to do the kneel.
LeBron James said he dedicated the emotional moment to Colin Kaepernick and said he hopes Cap's proud.
When they got to Orlando and he was going to be the face of the inequality, just like they chose Kaepernick to do the kneel.
Oh, they finna pour it on like water. Oh yeah, Black Lives Matter. What about Child Abduction Matters? When they gonna put that on their shirts? So so that the child abductors can get a little bit fearful. You know? What about child abduction? Over 300,000 kids snatched up. I ain't gonna let that number go. I'm gonna say that as many times as I get. 300,000 kids every year. That's not 300,000 kids every decade. That's 300,000 kids every year get snatched up in the United States alone. So why they don't have that sticker on their jerseys? Because this is propaganda. Why are the entertainers still moving around trying to entertain? This should not be a season for entertainment, right? They just pulled up on the TV talking about how many people, millions. I forgot the number. Millions have been, million cases, but 100-some thousand infected or something like that. 145,000 actually got it, but millions infected. So if it's spreading that fast, 8 million, 9 million or whatever, cases or whatever, why are they still going out and trying to entertain you?
Page through what that was like and if it mattered to you guys.
Well, the same energy that we have on the floor is the same energy that we have towards having justice for Breonna Taylor.
Y'all didn't hear that. So she asked him, she said, you know, what about that energy y'all had on the floor with no crowd? He said, well, the same energy we had on the floor is the same energy we got for Breonna Taylor. Now, do you understand now how he's pulling every question now back to inequality? Because he was trained to do this and he was told to do this in those secret meetings. And vexed him in his sore displeasure. See, the vexing in his sore displeasure will be his wrath that he's going to pour out on this land. And people can believe it or not, I know what the Lord is going to do to this land. I know what he's going to do. All right. So the fact that you have a mask on your face, but then you have a shirt on that say, I can't breathe. That right there is an oxymoron in itself, man. Baseball has Black Lives Matter on the mound. This land, I'm telling you, man, this land gonna get burnt up. And I know I keep saying that as if I'm not sincere to the people here and then like that, man. We see where it's headed. We see where this land is headed. How dare you put the word of God next to governmental propaganda? This is a reporter from Savannah said that she caught the COVID and that she had to go into like 11 days of rehab or isolation or something like that. But why am I putting her picture up here? Because I'm about to play some audio in a minute of them telling you that NBA players caught the disease or had the disease as well. And none of them looked it like this. If you saw her picture originally, you would say she looks dead now. This is how you know this thing. This is makeup. They made her look dead. All right. She's up here saying that she had disease. All these people are playing around, man. These people have a job to do. You understand me? People have a job to do. Like I told you, since the beginning of 2020, they've been riding you like a horse at a Kentucky Derby race. They've been riding your neck. They started out with the U.S.-Iran fake war. They fake bombed the general, Soleimani. Then they come around you with the Kobe fake death. Then the Donald Trump impeachment. Then Breonna Taylor racism. Then George Floyd racism. Then the corona hit you. Then the Ahmaud Arbery supposedly jogging and got shot. They hit you with that. Then the riots. Then the Atlanta Peace supposedly killing Rashad Brooks. Then the Black Lives Matter. And then they ain't on rest. They're going to keep their foot on the gas until they train your youth that is being raised up in the same way that they trained you.
Well, specifically, we haven't yet decided, Stephen A., but look. Change happens, I think, in two ways in this country and always has, right? I mean, first, it's people with status and power.
All right, now notice he's going to throw around this word power. He's going to throw that around a lot. He's going to be like, we need these people with power. These famous people with power. What do y'all feel about them constantly saying, because Steve Harvey say the same thing a lot. when he's addressing like Oprah. Oh, Oprah has a lot of power. She got all the power in the palm of her hands.
Now, I said no to some very powerful people. I said no to Oprah Winfrey. I said no to Tyler Perry. I said no to Lee Daniels. And I said no to Lionsgate.
And these three people,
yes,
not because they're powerful, but because of who they've come.
I don't think you can just throw around the word powerful just any kind of way you want to.
I mean, first, it's people with status and power and wealth. If the people that have the power in our society is in, because when we talk about the most powerful people in our society.
Here you go again with that powerful. When we talk about the most powerful people in our society, what makes a person powerful?
You know, you take, these are some of the wealthiest, most powerful people in the country.
It's like the veil was ripped off my face that they it's like they tried to glue a mask to my face with this Baphomet circus, and it's like the Lord just ripped the whole thing off.
When you look at even a situation with LeBron James, who's one of the most powerful athletes, one of the most powerful people in the world, he was told to shut up and dribble by a news anchor.
He can't be that powerful then. How powerful is he if he was told to shut up and dribble the basketball? Oh, LeBron James is one of the most powerful people in the world on the planet. But then he was told to shut up and dribble. So how powerful is he then?
Woman, right? He was told to shut up and dribble. And I stay in a community of 30 homes. We're the only African-American family here. And I watch, you know, other people ride golf courts and, you know, their kids ride their go-karts or whatever. But when my children do it, we get emails.
Kendrick Perkins said he moved into a neighborhood with 30 houses in the neighborhood. He the only black family in the neighborhood. So that's 29 other houses in this neighborhood. Now he trying to make up a story about him being oppressed. First of all, who told Kendrick to move to that neighborhood? And then when they drive their golf carts and they go-karts up and down the road, nobody says anything to them. But soon as your kids get on theirs, they send you emails and tell you to get off of them. See, he's lying, right? Ah, he's getting paid to lie. Let's back that up. Go ahead, Kendrick.
We deal with this at all different levels. And here I am, an African-American, and I stay in a community of 30 homes. We're the only African-American family here. And I watch, you know, other people ride golf courts and, you know, their kids ride their go-karts or whatever. But when my children do it, we get emails about it. Hey, can you please tell your kids to do this or do this? There's certain restrictions, to the point where, you know, a man was standing at the edge of the driveway yelling at my child, and I had to go down there and confront him.
Do y'all think Kendrick Perkins, somebody who has made probably roughly about $150 million in his career, is walking on eggshells in his neighborhood and he's not wanted in his neighborhood? Come on, man.
Our thanks to Paula for that report. And now joining us is Donovan Mitchell in isolation. It is great to see you, Donovan. First of all, how are you feeling this morning?
Great to see you too as well. Thank you for having me. I'm fine. You know, things are going well.
All right. So Donovan is in isolation, NBA player, and he has it. That's why he's being isolated, but he's fine. He's doing well. What about this lady who they put the makeup on, who look half dead? Is she doing fine? Is she doing well? She said it almost broke her down. It ran through her body. Tried to kill her. The thing ran through her body and tried to kill her. But then we asked the NBA player, I'm fine.
You know, things are going well.
You ask any of them, I'm doing well. I'm good. Why is there a difference? A lot of people say doctors. I'm going to say no. It's because they're contradicting themselves out here. That's what they're doing. And it's so much of a big contradictory, they're putting themselves in a state of mockery.
Here's the secret behind Trump's love of fast food.
How do you do it? What's your secret?
Trump's love of fast food is also a strategic choice. Trump has had a longtime fear of being poisoned, one reason why he liked to eat at McDonald's.
I don't want to go into a restaurant and say, Mr. Trump would like a hamburger to go.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know what they're going to do to that hamburger.
Amen, amen, amen. God bless each and every one of you today in a mighty, mighty way. May the love of God pour out unto all man. May the love of God pour out unto all men. What does Spalding mean? What does Spalding mean? Spalding is English and Scottish. It is an English-Scottish word coming from the tribe named the Spaldingers.
Who you going to the dance with anyway? Spalding?
Who's Spalding?
Okay, and that's on the basketball here in the U.S. Remember I told you it's a Roman day circus meant for distraction with a whole lot of witchcraft and magician work.
But there may be no connection that's more important to a player than his relationship with the basketball.
I'm not going to have a relationship with no one in my family, my mom, my wife, like I've had with the basketball.
For most, it's been that way since as long as they can remember.
But the lower level division is skin color. That's why you have the black and white chessboard at the lowest level, or whatever, skin color division. Then when you go to the second level, it's politics. Politics divide people, red and blue, Democrat, Republic. Then when you go higher than that, class of wealth divides people. That's why people like Bill Gates and Kanye and all of them are into the depopulation of mankind now when they enter into a certain tax bracket. If you understand this, this is why you have people, when they get like certain billions of dollars, then they get into the eradication of human beings, the killing off of human beings. When we go back to the NBA, you have the Eastern Conference and you have the Western Conference. Eastern Conference is blue, Western Conference is red. That's just a play on your mental right there. That's all a play on the mental right there. I told you they use a lot of magicians in basketball, they use a lot of witchcraft. Now we know that the Harlem Globetrotters ain't shooting no basketball blindfolded from one end of the court to the other one. It's a magnet in the ball. It's a magnet in the ball. It's a circus. It's a magnet in the ball. It's a circus. It's always been a circus, okay? So they play on the court. The courts stem back to the Roman courts. Go and look it up. They play basketball on a court. The court, when you go into a court of law, all right, most of the lawyers that are assigned to you, they're British bred. They're British bred lawyers. Now, this is how fake the NBA is. They want to pour on that propaganda and programming, so they fake a scene right here with Kenny. Those with a discerning eye and with the spirit upon them can see that this is fake. And also watch how Shaq keep looking down at the script to see when his part is coming up so he can come in on cue. And when Kenny takes off his receiver, check him out. He gonna look down at the script too. It's all staged to program you, every single bit of it.
Right now, my head is like ready to explode. Like just in the thoughts of what's going on. And I don't know if I'm even appropriate enough to say it. What the players are feeling and how they're feeling. And I haven't talked to any of the players. I'm just, but like coming in, even like driving here and getting into the studio, hearing calls and people talking. And for me, I think the biggest thing now is to kind of, as a black man, as a former player, I think it's best for me to support the players and just not be here tonight. And figure out what happens after that. Yeah, I just don't feel perfect.
And I respect that.
Thank you.
community of 30 homes. We're the only African American family here. And I watch, you know, other people ride golf courts and, you know, their kids ride their go-karts or whatever. But when my children do it, we get emails about it.
Amen, amen, amen. God bless each and every one of you today in a mighty, mighty way. May the love of God pour out unto all man. May the love of God pour out unto all man.
Started with JaVale getting shoved down the throat, so we're gonna keep our timeline over here as we get more information, right?
Not all. Look at his mouth. No homo.
Look, in basketball, you have what is called a time of possession. We know when somebody is possessed of a certain demonic entity or something like that, they're not of God. Time of possession. You understand what I'm saying? And then they shoot from the arc. We know that arc to be ARC, but we know it's a play on the actual arc. Okay, but we understand when we read the Bible that the serpent was the most cunning beast of the field. You're not to go in beast mode, and that's what the players are said to do, go into beast mode. When you carry the ball or whatever, they call that carry the cross. Anybody who's played basketball know that you can carry your cross. Crossover, carry the cross. Who do we know carried the cross? We know that Jesus Christ carried the cross, and we must take up our cross as well. Now, when you have certain teams that go to the playoffs, when they weren't supposed to be in the playoffs, they call that the Cinderella team because they weren't supposed to make it. Where do we know Cinderella and all that stuff come from? We don't have no queens here in the United States. We got one oppressor who taking instructions. So what? That goes all the way back to England. That goes all the way back to the English, man. You know what I'm saying? That's why they call the team the Cinderella team. And this is why you got people like King James. When you got a King James Bible, you got people like King James, you got people like Zion Williams and all these other names that's supposed to tie back in the biblical aspects going out there. Now notice, you got teams like Raptors, Pelicans, Bulls, all these teams, but you never hear teams about sheep or doves, huh? Sheep, doves, none of that, because we're in the land of Sodom and Gomorrah that's about to be burned, I'm telling you, man. Jerseys were being made in the medieval time, even all the way down to the Letterman jackets. Letterman jackets made in medieval time. The Letterman jackets come from the armor that the medieval knights were wearing in the days of old. But why do NBA players get paid 10 times more than everybody else? Think about that. Because the more you can distract and entertain, the more you get paid in this system that they're building up. Just distract and entertain. Don't teach truth. Fame is nothing in a temporary world, y'all. And I know I'm be hated by a lot of men lovers. That's what I call you, man. You like men lovers. You like to see men sweat before you go and get your spirit right. I understand. Men lovers. Like to see LeBron James change clothes in the locker room. But guess what? God said he shut down that circus. Did you pick up your word when he shut it down? That's the question. Y'all be cool like how y'all be cool. God bless y'all in a mighty way, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. And guess what? Any of y'all who going through something in your household, I rebuke any demon in anybody's household who's listening to this video. I rebuke any evil spirit out of anybody's household. The Bible says get the binding and get the loosing, because whatever you bind and loose on earth shall be bind and loose in heaven. So I pray against any spirit, the spirit of confusion, the spirit of doubt, the spirit of depression, the spirit of fornication, the spirit of just sinning against the Lord. I rebuke that out of your household. And may your household get back to the ordinances of God. May your household get back to love and not division. And y'all who are already walking in the love of God, continue to show the love of God to everybody you come in contact with. Because that's what a war is right now. It's spiritual. That's not what they're going to tell you on the news, though. That it's a spiritual war right now. The war on the land, they've been stopped at. They've been stopped doing wars on the land. But God said it's going to come a day. All these jokers who signed this little treaty together, they're going to war against each other. Now that's guaranteed. All these religions that have joined hands, they're going to war against each other. And you don't want to be here when they do it. I'm going to say that one more time, and that's it. There's no loyalty amongst thieves. It never has been. It never will be. Anybody with street smarts know this. You don't even got to be in the Bible to know this. There's no loyalty amongst thieves. You name me a treaty that has lasted forever. God said when they say peace and safety, then sudden destruction will come upon. Everybody who signed that pact and that agreement is going to last just for a time. Because there's no loyalty amongst thieves. But you don't want to be here when they go to warring against each other.